Hello mga kawaumat! In this video lesson, we will discuss about the equation of a parabola with vertex at HK. So from our previous video lesson, yung vertex natin na sa origin. So dito, yung vertex naman natin wala siya sa origin. So any part of the Cartesian plane natin matatagpuan yung vertex. So ito yung four equations na pag maging guide natin para alam natin kung ano yung orientation ng parabola natin. So, kagaya rin ng sa naunang video natin, so, ang titingnan lang din natin yung variable para alam natin kung ang parabola niya opens upward, downward, to the right, or to the left. So, once yung variable, walang exponent, no? So, yung variable na walang exponent, doon papunta yung graph natin. Doon, yung opening ng graph ng parabola natin doon sa variable na to. So, kagaya nitong dalawang equation natin, so, yung y variable, yung walang exponent. So, ibig sabihin, yung parabola natin towards y-axis. So, magbabago lang dito sa sign. So, kung positive yung sign, ibig sabihin, yung parabola natin opens upward. And then, kapag negative yung sign dito, yung parabola natin opens downward. And then, kapag yung x naman, yung x variable naman, yung walang exponent, ibig sabihin, yung parabola natin, yung orientation ng parabola natin, towards x-axis naman. So, it's either to the right or to the left. Kapag to the right, kailangan positive yung nandito. So, kapag to the left, so, kapag ang sign dito is negative, yung parabola natin opens to the left. So, yan lang yung tatandaan natin para alam agad natin na ganun yung opening ng parabola natin. And then, pagdating naman sa focus, itong gagamitin nating guide. So, for first equation, which is the parabola opens upward, the quantity of x minus h squared is equal to 4a times the quantity of y minus k. Yung focus natin dito, so yung coordinate ng focus natin is h and then k plus a. Once na nakuha kasi natin yung focal distance natin, madali na lang natin kunin to, yung focus saka directrix. So ito ay mga guide, no? Pwede nyong i-copy ito para guide nyo. And then, isa pa, so kapag yung h natin dito, that is our x coordinate. So lagi naman partner silang dalawa. At yung k naman, that is the y coordinate. So partner din palagi yung dalawa na yan, yung y saka yung k. Kasi yung k natin dito is the y coordinate. So tatandaan natin. Sa pangalawang equation, yung focus natin, h, then k minus a. Sa pangatlong equation, is the parabola opens to the right, h plus a, okay, yung x coordinate natin, tapos k yung y coordinate. And then, same with, kapag yung parabola natin opens to the left. So, babawasan lang natin yung h natin kung ano makuha natin focal distance, tapos k. Sa directrix, so susundan nyo lang to as guide. So, makikita nyo to, ma-encounter nyo to sa susunod na presentation ko. Okay? So, sa bawat isa na to, magbibigay ako ng halimbawa. For number 1, we have the quantity of y minus 1 squared is equal to 8 times x minus 4. So, yung unang yung titingnan dyan, yung variable na walang exponent. So, alin sa dalawa, y saka x, ang walang exponent, yung x. So, ibig sabihin, yung parabola natin, mag-o-open siya towards x-axis. So, sa right side ba or sa left side? Sa right side, since positive ito. So, the parabola opens to the right. Okay? So, sa right side, mag-o-open yung parabola natin papuntang right side. Kasi positive yun nandito, tapos yung exponent na walang variable, ay ang variable na walang exponent ay x. After that, kunin na natin yung focal distance. So, lagi nyo lang i-equals. So, 4a is equal to 8. Divide both side by 4. Okay, so 4a divide 4, the answer is a. And 8 divide 4 equals 2. So ito na yung focal distance natin. So ang focal distance, yan yung distance mula sa ano natin, sa vertex papuntang focus, vertex papuntang directrix. Okay, ito yung distance natin. Next is yung 2A. So, kukunin na rin natin yung 2A. So, para saan yung 2A? Kapag kukunin na natin yung isang endpoint o yung endpoint no, sa latus rectum natin from focus, so ito yung distance. So, 2A, so yung, since yung A natin is 2, so 2 times 2, that is 4. And then, sabi ko nga, so yung x coordinate natin is yun yung h. So, yung y minus 1, ito yung k. So, paano natin kunin yung vertex? Of course, dapat mauna yung sa h. So, paano natin kukunin? Solve for x, x minus 4 is equal to 0. Or, titingnan nyo na lang kapag negative yun nandito. So, ibig sabihin, positive yung h natin. Ganun din dito sa k. So, since negative, so positive 1. So, ngayon, makikita natin or matatagpuan natin yung vertex natin sa 4, 1. So, dito. So, nandito yung vertex natin. Next natin kukunin yung focus natin. So, yung focus natin gamit yung focal distance na 2, siya yung magsasabi kung saan natin makikita yung focus natin. Ngayon, since yung parabola natin opens to the right, so saan yung focus natin? Sa taas ba ng vertex? Sa baba? Sa left side or sa right side? Sa right side. Kasi opens to the right yung parabola natin. So, bilang tayo ng dalawa, so isa, dalawa. So, nandito yung focus natin. So, nandyan yung focus natin or pwedeng yung gamitin, no? Yung binigay kaninang guide. So, H plus A. So, yung H natin is 4. Dadagdag mo, i-add mo lang yung nakuha nating A. So, 4 plus 2 is 6. Tapos, yung K natin is 1. So, 6, 1. Okay? So, same lang. Okay? Parehos lang yun. Pareho lang yun. Pwedeng ito na yung gamitin nyo or pwede rin ito para ito guided talaga kayo. Next is yung directrix natin. So, yung directrix nating class, so kung ano, ilan yung minove natin papuntang right side, yun din yung distance papuntang left side para makuha natin yung directrix. So, laging tatandaan yung vertex, laging nasa gitna yan, i-focus sa kani directrix. So, kung dalawa, so dalawa din, 1, 2. So, nandito yung directrix natin. Or pwede nyo gamitin yung equation na x is equal to h minus a. So, yung h natin is 4 minus 2. So, yung a natin, so 2. Okay, so tama naman, no? 2. So, since sa directrix equation yung sinasagot natin dyan. So, x is equal to 2. So, ibig sabihin, lalagyan natin ng line. Okay, so vertical line ang ilagay natin. So, ito yung directrix natin. After that, yung axis of symmetry. So, yung axis of symmetry natin, kapag yung directrix natin vertical, yung axis of symmetry natin horizontal. Okay, kung saan yung vertex of course natin, dun natin i-ano natin yung axis of symmetry. Okay, tatandaan. Ito lang yung palatanda natin. Once na ang directrix natin vertical, yung axis of symmetry natin horizontal yan. Okay, so y is equal to 1. So, dito yan. Okay? So, ito yung 1 natin. So, ito yung axis of symmetry natin. Next is the latus rectum. Kukunin natin yung dalawang endpoint ng latus rectum. So, pwede natin gamitin, class, itong 2A natin. Mula sa focus natin, magmumove tayo ng 4 units. Papunta saan? Papuntang left ba or papuntang right? Or pataas, pababa? Since, yung parabola natin opens to the right, ibig sabihin yung movement na gagawin natin ay paakyat saka pababa. Okay? Or pataas at pababa. So, 4 units mula sa focus. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? O kaya, para di kayo malito class, yung axis of symmetry natin horizontal. So, pag horizontal yung axis of symmetry natin, pataas saka pababa yung movement natin pag kukunin natin yung dalawang endpoint ng latus rectum. So, again, dito natin kukunin. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, nandito yung isang endpoint. And then, sa baba naman, so 1, 2, 3, 4, nandito yung isang endpoint. So, that is, yung una, 6, 5. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, nandyan yung unang endpoint. Pangalawa, 1, 2, ay 1, 2, 3, 4. So, nandito yung pangalawang endpoint natin. 6, negative 3. So, once na nakuha na natin yung dalawang endpoint, again, yung 2A natin, ito yan. So, yung 2A, yan yung distance mula sa isang endpoint papuntang focus. So, pwede na natin i-graph yung parabola natin. Next is kunin natin yung length ng latus rectum. So, ito yon. So, kung bibilangin natin, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, that is 8 units. Ngayon, pwede naman gamit yung formula. Yung formula natin is 4A. So, yung A natin is 2. So, 4 times 2, that is 8 units. So, yan yung length ng latus rectum natin. Number 2, the quantity of y minus 3 squared is equal to negative 12 times the quantity of x plus 4. So, ulitin ko ulit, ano yung titingnan natin para alam natin kung ano yung opening ng parabola natin? Yung variable. So, yung variable natin class is x. So, yung x yung walang exponent. So, therefore, yung parabola natin towards x-axis. Since negative yung sign niya, negative itong sign natin, ibig sabihin yung parabola natin opens to the left, papuntang left side. So after that, kunin natin yung focal distance natin, yung focal distance natin. So kung negative dyan, negative din yung gamitin niya. So negative 4a is equal to negative 12. Then divided both side by negative 4. So negative 4a divide negative 4. The answer is A equals negative 12 divide negative 4, that is positive 3. So, yung focal distance natin ay positive 3. Next is yung 2A. So, 2 times 3, that is 6. After that, kunin natin yung vertex natin. Ito yung H natin. Ito yung K natin. So, yung vertex natin, since positive yun nandito, yung H natin ay negative 4. Then dito positive negative yung 3, so yung k natin is positive 3. So kunin nila yung opposite ng sign. So kung positive diyan, so negative yun dito. So kung negative diyan, positive yun. So matatagpuan natin yung vertex natin sa negative 4, 3. Saan yan? Nandito negative 4, 3. So nandito. So kunin natin. So nandiyan yung vertex natin, and then after nyan, kunin natin yung focus. So, yung focus natin gamit yung focal distance, which is 3. Since papunta tayong left side, so yung vertex, yung focus natin, nasa left side din ni vertex. Again, since papunta tayo sa left side, yung parabola natin opens to the left, yung focus natin, nasa left side din ni vertex. So, bilang tayo, so 1, 2, 3, ito yon. Siya yung magsasabi nung distance mula sa vertex papuntang focus. 1, 2, 3. So, nandito si focus natin. Or pwede nyo sundin, then gamitin tong guide na to na H minus A. Since yung H natin ay negative 4 minus 3, so that is negative 7. Tapos yung K natin, 3. So, negative 7, 3. So, nandito again, nandito yung focus natin. And then, kunin natin yung directrix natin. Yung directrix natin, kung 3 units yung distance mula sa vertex papuntang focus, so ganun din sa directrix. So 1 2 3, mag-move din tayo papuntang right side. So 1 2 3. So nandito yung directrix natin. Okay? Or pwedeng yung gamitin class, so lagyan natin ng vertical line. Pwedeng yung gamitin yung x is equal to h plus a. So yung h natin is negative 4 plus yung A natin at 3, so negative 4 plus 3, that is negative 1. So, nasa negative 1 siya. So, X is equal to negative 1. Next is axis of symmetry. So, yung directrix natin, vertical. So, ibig sabihin yung axis of symmetry natin, horizontal. And that is, saan makikita yan? So, kung ano yung Y natin sa vertex, yung Y coordinate natin sa vertex, that is the axis of symmetry. That is Y is equal to 3. And after that, yung endpoint ng latus rectum natin. So, yung endpoint ng latus rectum natin is gamit yung 2A natin, which is 6. So, magmumove tayo ng 6 units papuntang taas at pababa. Okay? So 6 units mula sa focus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So nandito yung isang endpoint. So that is negative 7 and 9. So nandito yung isang endpoint. And yung isa naman mula sa focus, baba tayo ng 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So nandito yung isang endpoint. And that is negative 7 and negative 3. So pwede na natin i-plot yung parabola natin. Okay, so that is our parabola. And then, yung length ng latus rectum, so kung bibilangin nyo lang, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 units yung length ng latus rectum natin, yung dalawang endpoint natin, so 12 units. Or using the formula 4A, so 4 times ang A natin is 3, so 4 times 3, the answer is 12. So ayan yun. Another example, we have the quantity of x minus 1 squared is equal to 8 times y minus 4. So 8 times y minus 4, tingnan maigi class, ang variable na walang exponent ay y. So ibig sabihin, yung parabola natin, mag-open siya upward kasi positive yun nandito. So the parabola opens upward. So solve for the focal distance, yung a natin. So 4a is equal to 8. Divide both sides by 4. So 4a divide 4, that is a, equals 8 divide 4, the answer is 2. And then 2a equals 2 times 2, since yung a natin is 2, the answer is 4. Our vertex, so yung h natin dito, ito yon. Ito naman yung k. So the vertex is, since negative, positive yung h natin. So positive 1 yung k natin, since negative nandito, so positive yung k. So that is 1, 4. So matatagpuan natin yung vertex natin sa first quadrant ng Cartesian plane natin. Nandito, so 1, 4. Then yung focus natin, gamit yung focal distance natin, since yung parabola natin opens upward, saan makikita yung focus natin? Sa taas ng vertex. Sa taas. Kung yung example number 1, nandito sa right side, kasi opens to the right yung graph natin, yung parabola natin. And then yung example number 2 natin, nandito yung focus natin sa left side ng vertex. This time, sa taas. Kasi opens upward yung parabola natin. So, bilang tayo ng dalawa, 1, 2. So, nandito yung focus natin. Okay? So, that is 1, 6. Or pwedeng gamitin itong coordinate natin, h, tapos k plus a. Yung h natin is 1, k is 4 plus 8, 4 plus 2, that is 6. So, 1, 6. After that, directrix. So, yung directrix natin dito, nasa baba ni vertex. So, bilang din tayo ng dalawa. So, 1, 2. So, nandito yung directrix natin. And that is y is equal to 2. So, ngayon class, kung kanina yung directrix natin, vertical line, yung line ng directrix natin is vertical. So this time, horizontal naman. So y is equal to 2. Once na yung directrix natin, horizontal line, ibig sabihin yung axis of symmetry natin, vertical. So nagpalit lang sila. Vertical, and that is x is equal to 1. So vertical yung axis of symmetry natin. And after that, kunin natin yung dalawang endpoint ng latus rectum natin. So, gamit yung 2A mula sa focus. So, paano yung movement natin? Kung kanina sa example number 1 and 2, pataas and pababa. So, dito, papuntang left saka papuntang right. Okay? So, papuntang left saka papuntang right yung movement para makuha natin yung endpoint ng latus rectum natin. And that is, so ilang units? 4. 4 units yung imumove natin. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, nandito yung isang endpoint. And that is 5, 6. At mula sa focus, move din tayo ng 4 units papuntang left. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, nandito yung isang endpoint. And that is negative 3, 6. Okay? So, pwede na natin. This is negative 3, 6 class. Okay? Edit lang natin. And after that, pwede na natin i-plot yung parabola natin. So, Yan. So, and after plotting the graph, next is kunin natin yung length ng latus rectum natin. So, pwedeng bilangin nyo or pwedeng using the formula. That is 4a, or yung a natin is 2. So, 4 times 2, that is 6. 4 times 2, that is 8 units. Okay, 8 units po. Alright, so last example. So, we have x plus 1 squared is equal to negative 1 half times y minus 2. So, ano yung variable yung walang exponent? Y. So, ibig sabihin, toward y-axis yung parabola natin. And that is, opens downward. Bakit downward? Kasi negative yung sign natin dito. So, kunin natin yung value ng a natin. So, negative 4a is equal to negative 1 half. So, divide both sides by negative 4. So, negative 4a divide negative 4. The answer is a equals negative 1 half times negative 4. Okay? So, kapag nagdi-divide tayo ng fraction, and then yung isa whole number, kunin natin itong reciprocal nito and proceed tayo sa multiplication. So, negative 1 half times negative 1 fourth, the answer is 1 over 8 or 0.125 sa decimal yan. And then 2a, kunin natin yung 2a, 2 times 1 over 8, so that is 1 fourth or 0.25. So, proceed tayo. So, yung h natin is negative 1. Yung k natin ay positive 2. So, again, titingnan nyo lang yung sign. So, kung positive yan, yung h natin ay negative 1. So, kung negative yan, yung k natin ay positive 2. Okay? So, minsan, class, tingnan nyo rin yung arrangement nila. Minsan, nandito yung x natin, nandito yung y coordinate natin. So, nandito natin makikita. So, makikita natin yung vertex natin sa negative 1, 2. Okay. So, negative 1, 2. So, ito yung 2 natin. Negative 1, 2. And then, yung focus natin, mag-move tayo ng 1, 8 or 0.125. So, saan natin makikita yan? So, mag-move tayo ng 1 over 8 mula sa vertex natin papuntang baba. Kasi opening, yung parabola natin opens downward. So, sa baba ni vertex yung focus natin. So, move tayo ng 1 over 8. So, that is negative 1. And, or kung kukunin natin kasi yung movement. So, gamitin nyo na lang to. Yung k natin is 2. 2 minus 1 over 8. That is 15 over 8. Oh. So, or that is, dito natin makikita yan. So, lagpas lang ng 1.8, no, bago dumating ng 1.9. And then, yung directrix natin, so yung minub natin dito, ganun din dito sa taas. Para makuha natin yung directrix natin. And that is 17 over 8. Kung ako sa inyo class, i-convert nyo into decimal para hindi kayo mahirapan i-plot yung points. So, 17 over 8. So, dyan natin ilalagay yung directrix natin. So, horizontal line yung directrix natin this time. And after that, kunin natin yung axis of symmetry. Since horizontal line yung directrix, automatic yan na yung axis of symmetry natin, opposite ng horizontal, that is vertical. Okay, so x is equal to negative 1. So, perpendicular lagi siya doon sa, ano natin, directrix natin. And after this, kunin natin yung endpoint ng latus rectum natin. So, pwedeng mula sa focus class, papuntang left side at right side, mag-add tayo ng 1 port. So, kumbaga, kung ano yung focus natin dito, mag-add tayo ng 0.25. Or pwedeng yung gamitin ito, negative 1 plus 1 port, tapos 15 over 8. Then, negative 1 minus 1 port, then 15 over 8. So, sa una, makuha natin yung negative 3 port or negative 0.75 and then 15 over 8. Okay, yan yon. And sa pangalawa, dito natin makukuha, that is negative 1.25. Okay, and 15 over 8. So, after natin makuha yung end point, plot na natin yung parabola natin. Ipa-plot lang natin yung parabola natin. Okay, that's open. Opens downward. So after that, kunin yung length ng latus rectum. So pagkuha ng length ng latus rectum, we have 4 times A. So 4 times 1 over 8, that is 1 half. So yung pagitan o yung distance nung itong endpoint na to papunta sa isang endpoint ay 1 half. So yan yung length ng latus rectum. So I hope nalinawan kayo kung paano i-plot yung parabola natin at kunin yung ibang parts ng parabola natin, like for example the vertex, focus, and directrix, the end point of latus rectum, and the length of latus rectum dito sa apat na example na binigay ko. Sa susunod na video lesson, magbibigay ako ng mas marami pang example, halimbawa hindi naman siya naka standard form, no? So paano natin i-graph yung parabola natin. So yan yung next na video lesson natin. After nito, pwede niyong panoorin din yun.
Thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button para updated kayo for more video tutorial. This is your guide in learning your math lesson, your WowMath channel.